Guys, thank you for tuning in. Welcome back. Obviously, as you can see me sitting here, that means Everest pulled a sickie after, two episodes? He's pulled a sickie. But having said that, I've got a special guest for us today. None other than Mr. As You Can See himself, my brother Monkweh.
Yes, Monkweh in the building. Mr. As You Can See, and if you don't know, you better know. What's going on, my people? Are we ready for today,
the
man?
The link has been long overdue, though.
Long overdue, man. First of all, I big up you guys, man.
Definitely, you guys are doing your thing.
Do you know what I'm saying? Obviously, my time, my schedule was a bit mad, but I wouldn't make time if I didn't rate your thing, man.
As you can see,
we're in the building, man.
For those of you that have been rocking with us, obviously we know that we play little games here and there just to sort of make the guests comfortable and all of us have a little laugh with it. So today we're going to play a little game. It's going to be different to the ones that we normally play. I'll just explain the rules for you lot. What I'll do is I'll play some songs. I'll play some, like, obviously very bait songs, but I'll pause the song. And every time I pause the song, you got to finish the lyric. Is that understood? Yeah. So I could play a song from the beginning, or I can play a song like a minute into the song and just to kind of throw you lot off. And then every time I pause it, it's the first person to shout the next line in the lyric.
Yeah. You get the point. Flop.
Yeah. I'll try to make it as nice and easy and as bait as I possibly can.
Yeah, please.
Look at this thing.
I thought this was a podcast. This is a karaoke competition. Wait. My brother.
Hey, bro.
Fam, let's go with it.
I got to catch you off guard, bro. You have to be prepared. Welcome to the dungeon, bro. Mad.
Welcome.
So I want to start with a nice, and I like to think a very easy one.
Go ahead.
Are you ready? Okay.
This, man.
Okay, let me.
Locked up there, but won't let me.
I'm gonna pause it first. Wait till I pause it.
Okay, cool.
My
car is stolen. Yeah. Registration.
Yeah.
Cops patrolling.
I'm rapping. Who got it first?
Locked up.
So what? There's no beep or anything.
The voice happened.
You don't have to sing.
I just gotta go. Whoever sings.
Say that. Yeah. I can't lie. I'm gonna be real with you guys.
Yeah, you can have that one.
Yeah, you say yeah.
I needed that one. That's it. Hey, I've done my part.
You see me on songs here, I don't know lyrics.
Bro, I'm shocked.
Like, I'll know like one word and then after I'm just...
After this, that's
you're in good company. Yeah. Me and him are...
That's what's going to make this fun, that. Because these two are terrible.
Yeah?
I'm shocked that he got that.
Well, only because that's a bait one. That's a bait one.
I have to make it. Please,
more of the same.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah, please.
If you're talking the hardest, geeks better pop up in your thoughts as an artist.
Jeez.
Talk to me. I was hoping you're gonna stop it. You know why?
Bro, I was hoping you're gonna stop it.
I wanted to. Should I keep playing a little bit?
Yeah, please.
Nah, go on.
I need a bit.
No, we know the lyrics though.
Everybody wants to know we're walking the park.
Is there anyone?
No, wait.
Do you know what's mad, yeah? People are gonna get onto me. Yeah. Like, how can you not know the anthem? Like,
this is the UK anthem. I'm shocked that you might know.
I know it, but I have to be in the vibe. Right now, I feel like that. If I get it wrong, I need to hear it. People gonna look at me and be like, "This guy don't know nothing."
You said it at the beginning bit.
Sporting Armani.
Yeah.
Wait, play it one more time, cause this is rude,
man.
Yeah,
you have to go back. I need the rhythm.
Sporting Armani.
Half of the crowd will snort in my Charlie. Okay, so now you know I'm safe.
Hey,
I'm just safe. I don't even want to print. I just want to be safe from the UK. Like, when they say this guy don't know nothing, I ain't fam, I'm safe.
About to get cancelled real quick.
Yeah, they go, you don't know that.
So that's 1-1. What's that? You need to catch up.
I know, let me get 0.5 in this.
Nah, I'll give you that one. You got 1 point.
Cool.
You got a point. Calm. I'll give it to you. Are you ready?
Oh my days, 1 second. Oh yes. Hey.
Mm.
One, two, three, and two. Now four. Are you mad? No, wait, this is not fair. One second. Hey, bro. That has to be. No, you know what?
That's my tune, bro.
The beat was still going in my head.
You know, I heard it over here.
The beat was still going in my head.
Well, I came out of his mouth.
You did start first. I know.
Literally came out of his mouth over here.
Yeah, sorry, but not sorry.
But you know what? In my head, it was still going.
Yeah, I know.
He was into the song.
Hey, that's a rhythm, yeah. Though. Hey, shot.
It is all right.
I'm trying to. Okay.
That was a good idea. Yeah,
don't worry.
Cool.
I don't want you to get angry with me.
No.
Okay, you not ready?
Yeah.
Oh, here we go. This is where
it's a big song.
I know the song. I don't know the lyrics.
Yeah, this one's a pass, man.
I'll let it simmer for a bit so you can catch the rhythm.
That Weekend?
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know this one.
Just give me the line.
Yeah? From when I pause it.
Why are you bothering?
But it's before that. There's something before that.
Something here for the week.
Loving the crew.
That was before that.
Oh. Loving the crew. Ain't that it?
Nah. Okay, I'll skip it. You lot don't know. I'll skip it.
Now play it.
I feel like I had it.
I'll skip it. I don't know what you mean about me. This is my
guy. Just out of my mouth. You're not going to suffer that bit. The bit where we know.
Everyone's just like this.
The bit that we know.
I know you were going to stop it.
Bam, hey, bam, when you paused it, my mind paused it. Bro, my brain stopped.
I was going to try to risk that one.
Oh, that one.
No.
The banner is a new risk.
What?
Risk it.
No.
But if you play a little bit more, I think I can get it, you know.
Bro.
Okay, maybe I'm trying. She
got a thing for the...
Is it Don Perry?
No. This guy's terrible.
The Dolce & Gabbana, something.
Yeah, but it's something before that.
Yeah, what are you saying? You know all the lyrics?
I know most of them, bro. Don't judge me, guys. Okay, I'll make it easy for you. Like. I know
you
smell the perfume,
the makeup on the shirt. You don't believe me.
Welcome to the party, bro.
He's got it. He's got it.
Okay, I'll do a couple more, and then we'll kind of move on from here.
Let me buy you a drink. Yeah. I'm T-Pain.
You know me. You was watching his hand press pause.
No man, bro. No man.
Give us a second.
Give us
a second, bro.
I'll use everything, bro.
Okay. Let me go. Okay. Ooh, let me go here. We all grew up to this guy. So there's no way none of you man should not know. We all grew up to him. This is our era.
King David.
Stop it. Do you know it? I think so.
I'll maybe skip a bit.
Why are you doing that?
In front of me, was it a beautiful body?
Yeah.
Come on.
Listen, I did the extra lyrics. Yeah.
I'm happy to share it. It's my brother.
So
what's this one you got?
Huh?
You got three.
Some say.
And you've got?
One.
Some
you
say.
One. And what quit you got?
I got four. I cannot lose. I know. Yeah.
Let me try to throw you man off.
I know the tune as well.
Backstreet Boys.
You are my point.
I can't lie though. 3-2.
I was about to. Hold on. I thought I had it.
No. Wait. It's three. I got three. Somehow.
Has he got three?
My brother. Okay. He's my manager, you know.
If the brother's my manager, you got this.
4-3-2.
If the brother's in the
Who tried to what?
4-3-2.
No, wait. I swear it's a 3-3-2.
No, this is... I swear man's on four. A manager.
Look at this guy.
He's my manager as well, no?
3-2-3-3.
Me at 3 or 4?
Yeah. No. It looked like he was winning.
Hey, I'm getting robbed here. Shot.
There's refs in the back.
You shared something with mine.
What tune? I can name the tunes.
That's it. So they said, Monkweh 3. Okay, perfect.
I swear I had 4, but we'll go back. VAR.
City.
You are now rambling. with 50 Cent. You gotta love it.
Cash sounds in my 745. You drive me crazy, shorty.
And it's even you're next to me.
Girl.
You
drive me crazy, shorty.
Wanna see and feel you next to me.
Yeah, I wanna
see
one. You.
It's not one.
Need to see. Come on, bro. Give me my points. I the winner. It must be. That's it.
Monkweh.
Winner.
Fam, I don't even know how I won that.
I think I got robbed, but we'll check it in VAR.
Later on, you look at it when you look watch it back. But well, thank you for that segment there. Thank you for joining us.
Yeah.
Now let's get the show cracking. I wish I could play music all day long. That's my turn.
I was gonna go yard.
That's what I normally cut out of it. This is when I normally tap out. After the little vibe session, I'm out, and then these sort of carry the show, and we just sort of go from there. Okay. And I write with side.
Sometimes.
Yeah.
Sometimes.
I said I'm the vibe man. I'm gonna give you the vibes, and these guys are just gonna give you whatever they got. Like.
Yeah. We'll try something.
Let's see. Now, JK, let's go.
Now, obviously, what we wanted to talk about, obviously, just talk about your journey up to where you are now. And obviously, inshallah, where you're going to go to be. Because obviously, I still feel like you haven't fully scratched or even touched your potential of what you can, like, go to. Or, like, obviously, we respect you in high regards. Yeah. And we think that you're going to, it's about time, innit? So, with you time, inshallah. But obviously, we just want to talk about your journey and, like, where you sort of started from. And, like, what made you sort of, what was your inspiration to get into this sort of lane?
Do you know what's mad, yeah? I've told this story so many times that, I feel like when people then watch podcasts, they can be like, we heard this one at that.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. But do you know what? Like, I'm going to try to remix it in a sense of like.
Yeah, we prefer the remix.
Yeah. Like, it's still a real story, but I'm going to maybe add a bit more flavor. No, I'm joking. You know what? I grew up to like shows like Fresh Prince and Keenan and Kel and all of these shows. And I always thought to myself like, yeah, man, it would be good if I could ever have a show. But then I thought you'd have to be in Hollywood and. It just seemed difficult, you know what I mean? But it was something I did want to pursue. But when it comes to like, you know, like my parents, we're from Sudan, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. So like education is so big for them. You know what I'm trying to say? So
we
you
know,
guys
bro.
Already know. So
yeah, we know.
It's not a thing where I can just go to my dad and say, I want to do that. Especially where we come from, but it's not you get me?
It's not going to happen.
It's either a doctor, engineer, or lawyer. Them three.
Front three.
Like, it's just weird. Like, so that was that. But, I remember like talent shows and stuff like that. I just loved it. I don't know. I remember the first time I done a talent show was at primary school.
Mm.
And I just remember like just the reception I got. And I thought, this is me.
This is it.
But remember I was doing, I don't even want to hurt the thing.
Don't be shy.
You got served like a little pony. My credit was about a million talents. No, I didn't have the belly at the time, but fam,
Why I laugh, because I was watching something the other day, and obviously I saw a clip of you talking about on the talent show. I saw you do the moonwalk.
That's a different. Moonwalk was crazy.
Wallah, it was crazy. I can't lie.
What? That moonwalk
was smooth.
It was so clean. When the cleaners came, they said, who came? It was hey, brother. That moonwalk nearly got me a job.
And you went from one end to the other, smooth, or like.
It was, bro. Yeah, that moonwalk was rude. Even when I watched, I said, sweat down. It was rude. That moonwalk. Yeah, but that happened in college. But that's what I'm saying. I loved doing the talent show.
Yeah.
Like every time there was a moment where you know, like there was like a competition or a talent show, I'd just jump in. It would be either break dancing. Like
so whatever it was, you just be on
Yeah, or do you know what I mean? And then one time I came across one DVD, Def Comedy Jam. And that's when I realized.
Them old school ones,
No, back in the day, it's mad.
Everyone borrowed that DVD.
It was, bro, it was a mad one. Like, so I remember watching one and, you know how it does, like, you know, like Martin Lawrence and them. Like,
yeah, yeah, of course, yeah, yeah, yeah.
See how hyped the crowd.
Yeah, it's crazy.
I said to myself, nah.
And back then it was a small, intimate stage and crowd, yeah, yeah, like, you're.
And it weren't like, yeah, and it weren't like how it is now. Back then, like, if you were shit, people were actually, yeah, like, they'll finish.
It was, yeah, 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 yeah,
weren't polite with it.
They're doing arenas and that.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You can't hear what they're saying, but them days, you hear it.
Yeah.
You'll hear it.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. I remember I come across that and I said, nah. Mm. So I already loved the attention of, like, whenever I did, like,
when he's on stage and.
But I said, this one is crazy. Mm. This is something I need to really do. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So I remember the first time I ever done stand-up comedy was at college. And that was the same night I done the moonwalk. So
oh,
remember, I done two performances in one night. I was at KSI on that fight. That's what, you know, that's me. Like, I just love the stage.
That's mad.
Well, they both planned the moonwalk and then the.
So what happened with that one is my brethren at the time,
yeah,
his segment was Michael Jackson.
Okay.
But he was running out of moves and his moonwalk weren't moonwalking. It was more star work.
Yeah.
It wasn't even the moon. The walk was just it. Wasn't a walk like, so I said, it was hurting me.
Yeah. That's your guy, isn't it?
Yeah, that's your guy. Said,
no, like, yeah, he's my guy, but you hear me?
I'm also just a Michael Jackson, yeah.
Michael Jackson.
Oh, yeah, 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 yeah,
said,
yeah.
That's your guy. So yeah, Michael Jackson. So no, you're. Nah, it was paining me because I was like, come on, man.
You can't buy it.
This is
Billie
Jean. This is Billie Jean, not Billie Denim Jean. It's Billie Jeans. You better do this properly. Like, so boom, now I said, nah. As he was dancing, it just seemed like he was repeating moves.
Oh, okay.
And then I said,
I need to come in.
I came, bro. Not only did I come in, I came in, I jumped off stage. When I came in, people were already moving nuts. Like, and then I jumped off stage. And I started dabbing people. You know when you come out some, you know, like a
yeah, 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 yeah.
But I was dabbing people, bro. Even motherfuckers I didn't like.
Bro.
Yeah.
But, that.
Bro, I felt like the guy.
Yeah.
That moment, and then I went up
the stage feeling.
I done the moonwalk. I went off the stage. I done another moonwalk. Nigga, that show, brother. That show wasn't even his anymore.
It was yours.
And remember. I still had a comedy, stand-up comedy set. The first
So that was before, so you did the moonwalk before you came on set?
Yeah, yeah. So I already gave him the start. The main course was coming. But the mad thing is, yeah, I've never done stand-up.
Okay.
But I thought, okay, cool. I kind of like looked at, I was watching the Def Comedy Jams to see what type of things that they talk about. So I said, cool. So I'm going to kind of relate it to my thing.
Okay.
Yeah. Do you know what I mean? And then I remember, like, so obviously I shut down that side of it, and then after they call my name up to do the stand up, and you know how they usually get onto people like in Def Comedy Jam.
Yeah.
I got onto this brother, and it just went crazy.
Oh, so you just stuck it on someone?
I stuck it on somebody,
and you just ran off.
Yeah,
there's always that one person. Always near the front of
yourself. No, but the thing is, that was literally. I just stuck it on one person, and then boom. Bro, do you know what with stand up? The key to stand up, what I believe is once you. Like, once you hit them with the first joke and they're loving it, like, the first joke is like probably the most important joke.
If you
flop that the second joke,
sets the tempo,
it sets the, that's it. No, but if you flop the next one, they just like you, anyways.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You can pick it back up. Yeah. So, with that one, it was nuts. It went crazy.
Do you remember it?
I remember it, but you get me?
Yeah, different time.
Yeah.
You remember it?
I don't work now.
After you gotta tell us, I need to hear that one.
Yeah, it was. Bro, it popped off, kicked off.
Energy high.
Energy was, brother.
The room was jumping.
It was, yo, the way I felt,
How long did you kill the youth for?
Huh?
How long did you kill the youth for?
Bro, it was a one murder. Hey, fam, it was a sacrificial lamb thing. Bro.
Just the one.
Wicked. But you know what? The room erupted so bad, like, it was so crazy that I didn't even have to drop any, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Remember, you don't need to go in. When you do go in, it becomes too much.
You don't
know what I'm saying? Like, right now, when you've told me about how this whole journey, I didn't want to give you the same thing, because in my mind, I've said this like 10 million times in four different podcasts. So I'm going to give you guys still the same story, but... Yeah, me.
It's a little bit,
I'm figuring it out. But yeah. So that was that, and then boom. I just things started to progress, and then the whole evolution of like the internet and social media that when that started to evolve.
Was that ever something you were like, obviously you started doing up stand-up, and then obviously was you thinking about going into stand-up, or was you always like, you know what, let me try this internet thing?
I said, let me try that, because remember the internet thing wasn't popping off like how it is now. So the stand-up was just, it felt like a drug, like this whole attention type of.
I can imagine it being it though, like, it especially if you want it. Bro, as well.
I remember after the show, I was running to catch my bus, and there was people at the bus stop. I felt like I didn't deserve to jump on this bus. Yeah. Where's the lemon? Like, it was rude, man. And then I remember coming into college. Remember, this is a college talent show.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You must have been the man in the college.
I was feeling like
that next day. You must have felt like,
Felt
like Stone Cold. You must have walked through the stage.
Dashing the can,
you know, swearing and walking by yourself.
Bro, I felt like, I felt like nobody could talk to me.
I can imagine.
Yeah, I was just like,
you feel like that though.
Oh my God.
You probably never came in the next day.
I wouldn't.
No. The thing is,
he had to get his email.
The thing is,
you had to come in. You know, that's the worst one. You don't even want to come in, but your email is red.
That's 30 pounds. Yeah. It's a lot.
To come in.
You know what it is? The man them tried to bring it back up so we can. Don't get me wrong. It's not like the guy was my brethren, by the way. Like,
you're just killing your friends, bro.
He wasn't like my dog, but he was like part of the batch.
The circle,
He's the type that would have come on stage and it would have just been a cussing match type of thing.
Oh,
you
know
what I'm trying to say? Because that's what we kind of did at first time anyway.
Yeah.
So people tried, the man them tried to like start
bring
that,
it back out. Yeah. That's how I was in college as well, because man them were trying to make it a violation.
You know what I mean? So my man felt like he had to come back.
Come back,
Do you know what I mean? He's a real G for, like, you know what I'm saying, holding it down. He held that corn, boy, definitely, man. But you know what I'm saying? But he said to man, you know what? I was gonna come. He didn't know. He didn't know.
Shout out my brother.
He didn't know what monster he started, you know. Bro, no, but big up to him still. But yeah, man, that for me, was the start of like my whole stand-up career type of thing. But I didn't think of it as a career. I didn't even know like where the hell you'd go to even make bread from it. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I wanted to ask you. So you know,
after that was it, like
during that time, what was in your head? Was you thinking, I'm just doing it as a passion, I enjoy it, or was you thinking there's a way to make
this? Is the thing, I saw it on Def Jam,
yeah,
and I just wanted that feeling, because remember, I've done talent shows,
I'd
do like Michael Jackson, or I do whatever, and it was always like, and do you know,
you
what I mean?
Never thinking this could be a way to bust,
I never thought, where'd you start, where'd you go? That's the whole thing.
So
my mind is like, you have to be in America for these things to happen, because
naturally,
that's where I thought, that's why the whole shows and skits and anything never came to mind. I always had it in my mind that I wish I could do it, but
there was no avenue at that time.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah. So obviously after college, then went to University Brunel. Shout out to the man them whoever went. Anyways, so I went to Brunel University to study computer science. And then obviously more talent shows and more things started to come.
Because it's more in uni, isn't it? When you're doing it in uni, it must have been a lot more now.
Let me tell you where the social media video type thing started. And it's mad because I remember at university, so I'd done another stand-up show at like in the ends there was like this, you know, sometimes they have these fun fairs and these functions, what I'm saying. So I done another stand-up and I killed it there. Well, I think I did, because everybody, you know what I'm saying? If I probably hear the jokes now, I'll probably be right, I got away with that. You know what I'm saying? But
it worked at the time.
It worked. I don't care, man. I survived. Anyways, it was good. I thought, this comedy, you know what I'm saying? And then done another talent show at uni, but I done a spitting bars. I was just spitting bars. But the way I came out on the entrance, my entrance was just like, it was crazy. And
you look like you was about to.
It wasn't
the
even
bar
a mad entrance, huh?
You look like you was about to say the bar.
Nah.
I had to drop it. I give him a beat, man.
Nah, but you know the mad thing. You know the mad thing is, the entrance wasn't crazy. It was just more the way I just flung the curtains.
Oh, okay.
And the man just stood there. You know when Michael Jackson just jump off from the thing and he stands there?
And people are fainting and that.
That's the feeling he's looking for. That's the feeling he's looking for.
No one was fainting. In my mind, the whole crowd fainted. Like, you know what I'm saying?
You gotta gas yourself up, bro.
But the way I done it, yeah, it was gassy. Like, if I saw anyone do that, I would have said, nah.
Yeah.
I would have, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. The way I done it, bro, I wish I had a footage for it. I wish I had the footage for it. But if I do, I will send it for you. Send it to you guys.
I hope so.
The way I just, and I stood there, I didn't even move, bro. And in my mind, I thought I was Michael Jackson.
Yeah.
And man, I would go, bah, bah, wavy. And then
sounds
I
like a movie.
Then I started to spit the bars.
And everyone goes crazy after
that. I tried to do the mad thing, yeah. Usually in my mind, I start spitting the bars and then jump off stage and everything.
Mm.
But I started to walk off the stage. Not walk off the stage, but jump off the stage. But as I was, and then start spitting my bars from the crowd.
Yeah.
That would have been, it would have been much more effective if I started spitting the bars and then jumped into the crowd.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
I was so... I didn't follow my
You was inexperienced then, bro. It's okay.
There you go.
In the moment.
And you're in the moment. You're not thinking when you're in the moment, bro. You're just going.
You know the mess up. So after that hype start, do you know the messed up thing? As I was coming down, mic in the reception, you can hear it just went going wild at that moment. But then obviously I picked it back up and it shelled. I done my thing. Done my thing. And then there was another night where there was an open mic night at uni. And I thought, cool, I went to it. I wasn't due to perform anything, I didn't, but like, it just seemed like it weren't kicking off.
Yeah.
I tried to do the hero thing. So I said, cool. I didn't have nothing rehearsed. I thought,
I'm just gonna vibe.
Freestyle.
These motherfuckers love me anyway.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Cause like, I was just that one of those guys that was just cool with everyone. You know what I'm saying?
Mm.
Like amongst like a lot of other characters who were just cool people. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
These people love me anyway. So I went up there and wallahi, bro, I swear on my life, I had a wavy joke, but it didn't kick off. Brother, I bought. I remember. You know my moment, yeah? You see that moment, yeah? I felt like
wanted the floor to swallow you.
Brother, yeah. I felt like my soul came out and looked at me and said, brother.
You're the sacrificial lamb.
You know, as you can see, brother,
today you are the sacrificial lamb.
It's like my soul came out and looked at me and said, motherfucker, you didn't have to.
You didn't. Especially because the fact that you went there to be a hero.
Yeah. To be a hero.
That's what hurts.
But the maddest thing is, I had a wavy joke, man. I know the joke was, do you know what I mean? Yeah. I know I could kick things up.
Do you remember the joke?
Allow me, innit? I don't want, my soul is coming out and looking at me like, brother, not now.
No, not today.
Don't try to figure this shit out.
Don't do it again.
You're all right now. You're in a good space right now. Brother, but I'll tell you. So, boom. Now, but this is where the story gets a bit. Mm. My mind, I said, cool. I needed to run. In my mind, I was gonna run. But you know what? I felt like, cause the mood was dead anyways, I felt like people, it just weren't that type of vibe.
Yeah.
But I said, you know what? If I run, I have to come back to uni again.
And you're done.
So I'm gonna just take the corn. So I sat in the middle of the crowd on some. If you're gonna corn me,
I'm here.
And I just couldn't take it. Like, I said,
I rate that confidence.
Went back up on, after. And I spat bars. I need to do myself. I ain't leaving.
He said,
I spat the same bars I spat the other shot.
Did it work?
Do you know what? Yeah.
Wait. What was the reaction?
It was people rated the
fact that. Okay. So you brought it back.
You brought it back.
No, not even brought it back. He didn't run from it.
Yeah.
And not only that, he come back on stage.
And done his thing.
So after I'd done that, people were like, Ansam,
It was
kind of a sympathy one, but fuck it, I'm going to take that one.
Yeah,
I'm going to take that one. Excuse my language. But I said, you know, I'm going to take that one.
Yeah.
At the end, I tried to do some speech. If you didn't like that one, I remember my bedroom was looking at me like, yo, it's calm now. Like, you saved yourself a bit.
In the moment, right?
Get off stage. I was like, I saved. So I got off stage and then boom. Now, this is where it gets. I'm feeling it now, bro.
Mm.
I'm like, yo, let me get some water for this because.
Yeah.
Even my manager had to check. He's on the page, you know what I mean?
It was so synchronized. Hey, he got up as well.
Fam. Mother, it was, I remember now, I felt like this was it. Like, F this whole comedy thing, man.
I'm out.
I'm out. Remember my bridging. Shout out to Mo, man. Mo Shimsho, my nigga, bro. Yeah, again, not meant to be saying N words and all that. I'm gonna try and keep it easy, yeah. So boom, now I remember he said, yeah, jump in the car. He saw, man. I was like, remember, I'm this comedy is my things, my characters, kind of what made it true with a lot of things, like, you know what I mean? I remember I just felt like it was over for me, like, do you know what I mean? Remember he jumped in the car, man took man to this kebab shop. We went to a kebab shop, just kicking it. He's like, Monzz, man, just relax. And I was just like, brother. What's going on, man? What's going on? Like, I felt like I was losing myself. Like, but it seems funny. And right now I can laugh about it. But at that moment, I felt like, it's like, you know, everybody when they grow up, they want to be a footballer. They had that dreams of being a footballer. Yeah. And then after you realize you're at that age where
it's not happening.
Yeah, it's not happening. Yeah,
the knee injury.
You already know. Brother. I felt the knee injury, bro. Yeah. No, comedy thing.
It's not happening.
Yeah, comedy injury, bro. Brother. And then he was just like, bro, like, it happens. Like, go watch that. Happened to Dave Chappelle and all of that. China. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I didn't know. But,
but you needed to hear that.
But let me tell you, yeah. If it wasn't for my man, I wouldn't be here right
now. That's
mad. Mm. I have to big him up, man.
That's
Shimsho,
mad, yeah.
My
big him up, my lad.
Yeah. I remember, yeah. And then I said, cool. Like, just kind of go off my chest, whatever. Like, I still like, just whatever. I remember Arsenal versus Leeds when Henry came back.
Oh, I remember that.
That was a mad thing.
I wasn't even an Arsenal fan and I got goosebumps. So, like, that gassed me.
That was a football fan. That was a football fan.
That one, anyways, when I remember we was at the uni, like, the area, the student union area, we were watching the game.
Yeah.
I remember Henry scored. I went nuts. Everyone went nuts. But, brother, I was hugging. Bro, I lifted up one random brother for no reason. Like, I was gassed, bro. And I remember I was so gassed, I went yard and I filmed myself explaining the whole Henri finish, like on a gas thing, like mad. And then I posted it on Facebook. It went viral. Oh. It went crazy.
So that was your first viral?
That was my first viral moment. Okay. Yeah. No, actually, Mango. That was my first viral moment.
We'll talk about the Mango Lassie because that one killed me.
That one there went viral. And then you got that
feeling back, yeah.
The book of tea, like, you know. I felt like, you know when Thor gets the first stone.
Yeah,
I felt that power and the first stone. I thought, yeah, brother. People are like, yo, we need more of these type of things. Do you know what I mean?
So that's when you sort of transitioned away from.
So yeah, the video type of thing now. Then Keek. If you remember Keek, it was like a video app. It's like an Instagram, but for video.
Oh, yeah, the app.
Totally
forgot about that.
Well, I forgot about that as well.
Yeah, so I remember I started to do videos and there, and started to kick off, bro. It was kicking off. Oh, by the way, I need to say this as well. On that night where I bombed, yeah, guess the brother that come up to me and said, bro, like, don't worry about it. Like, you get me? But man, seen you perform. Remember, there's man them that didn't come up to man. Like, man them that, they know what this comedy thing means to man, like, you know what I mean? But this brother, he come up to man and he said, bro, like, we know what you're on, man. You do this thing that, like, don't watch that. It happens, man. You can pick yourself up and, you know what I mean? This is before Shimsho, put man in the cab and in the car and went and jumped up. Do you know what I'm saying? Guess who it was?
Someone.
Damson Idris from Snowfall.
No way.
I swear down. That's my brother, man. Shout out to Damson, man.
No way.
Yeah, Damson's my guy, man. Like, you know what I'm saying? Mm. Obviously, at university, like, everybody had their own kind of cliques, but because we're all in the same year, we're all, like,
in and around each other. And,
you know what I mean? Yeah. So, man, Esports, Man United, I sport Arsenal. Oh, yeah. We always had that. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I'm not going to do the whole, oh, this was my guy, because he's made it. Yeah. But he was my guy, though. Like, whenever I see him, he knows who I am. I know him. Yeah. It's love all the time. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? But we never chilled unless we was at a motive. You know what I'm trying to say? So I'm not going to come in and be like, oh, yeah, that's my... You know them guys? Yeah.
No,
like,
there's a lot.
But that's my... But a man got huge... That's so much love for him.
So happy for him. Massive bits.
What? He's doing...
He's gone.
He's gone clear.
But even him going clear, he's still checking up on my stuff. Like,
I see him comment on some of your posts.
You know what I'm saying? Mm. That's my brother. And obviously he's got his peoples now comment. It's mad.
That's
like,
massive.
See,
yeah,
see
yeah,
how
yeah,
powerful
yeah,
like words are, like in your moment of need. You know, like bro, not even in need, just when you're not feeling
that's what, exactly.
Those words can be powerful, bro.
It's so big.
Yeah.
And the maddest thing about that is I remember it like it's years
yeah,
ago.
Yeah, it's a,
and
it's
I remember
a big moment.
And I remember him,
moment,
I remember yeah, when, and it's mad like.
But that's why it's always important to have like clean-hearted people like that around.
Yeah.
And now on the flip side of it, there's man that'll be like, "Oh, this ain't
bro, he
you,
said
bro."
It. But then people it, wasn't coming and checking.
Yeah.
Like,
well, no, but there's yeah, some guys that will actually come and chat to you and be like,
"That's a breezy."
Oh, you
man,
know what? Just,
nah,
just leave it.
Let me tell you what. Let me tell you what happened. Oh, that's breezy. The camera's not that 4K on that.
he had a howler.
That was a howler. Hey, where's the man of the day? Where are you gonna say that? It happened. Where are the man's gonna say that? It happens. That was a howler. Anyways, bro. But let me tell you where this gets sweeter, though.
Okay.
So I remember now, yeah. Cool. Remember I sat in the middle of the crowd, blah blah blah, 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 just whatever, man. If you're gonna roast, man, just get over with, like, do you know what I mean? I remember one brother tried to do the whole funny man thing when I went around. Oh. Obviously, like, oh, do you remember when Monzz blah blah blah
yeah,
tried
yeah,
to
yeah,
get me? Mm. Like, get me? Yeah. I remember another brother come and told man like on some, yeah, my man tried
to
say
about you. Yeah.
And it's calm. If you're gonna do it in front of man,
but not yeah, behind my back.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But different, when you're trying to do it behind my back, it's like, as I said, if it's my boy, if it's my boy, because I know he'll do it in front of my face.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Between laughing with me and laughing at me.
Yeah, yeah.
They're two different.
Like obviously, if me and you now here and you weren't here, I could say a joke about you because you're.
Yeah, yeah, but that's what.
No,
because you do it in front of him.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
this brother didn't. Let me tell you why this gets sweet. Yeah. Let me tell you why this gets sweet. I'm not gonna say the name, but I hope you're watching this and he knows I'm talking about him because he doesn't know that I know.
Oh, okay.
You are a bastard. Simple. You're a bastard. But let me tell you why this gets sweet. I'm not gonna say the
no
name.
No sugarcoat.
But the clues will allow him not to know who he is.
Okay.
The bastard. Absolute complete.
I just want
anyway, no. Nah. So boom now. Boom, he tried to do that. Man them gave me the report. Hey, my man's trying to you get me buzz off your thing, blah blah blah. And I'm like, raw, like, cool, calm. But it weren't a thing of where I was gonna go approach man and say, why you trying
to
yeah, 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 it's not that deep, yeah, but you
not
know.
That deep.
Yeah, it's noted.
But in my mind it was he's always had the sly comments whenever I'd done something and it popped up.
It was making sense.
So then when this crumbled, it was like, yeah.
He was happy. He was waiting for that day. He was waiting for that.
Like, do you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You ready, yeah?
Yeah.
You ready?
Ready.
See how this thing is popping off now?
Mm.
Imagine this bear message, man. Remember, I'm a grown
oh,
man.
Oh,
yeah.
I'm grown. He doesn't know. I remember this. Remember, I remember these things because these are pinnacle things in my
pinnacle
life.
Moments,
these
yeah,
are,
life.
These are things that really.
It motivates you as well, though. Well, like, if you're on a deeper level, that's the type of shit that
but
gets
remember,
you going.
But remember, I'm kind of forgiving as well in a sense.
Yeah,
like, you get me?
Yeah.
Imagine this bear, yeah. He messaged man. I like something early in the morning, talking about, "Hey, yeah, you're doing your thing, man. We should link up together and write skits together." You are a bastard. You're a fool. You are a fool. A complete fool. A legendary fool. A fantastic.
Legendary fool.
Because he doesn't understand yet. Yeah, no.
Oh, shit. Man said a legendary fool.
No. And the reason why I'm doing this is because it's like, brother, I know from back in the day you don't want me.
Yeah.
To,
yeah.
You weren't really feeling my thing.
You don't want it. But now it's unstoppable. Like, you can't stop me.
Fact.
I'm on smoke on comedy.
No,
thing.
Fact.
Do you know what I'm saying? And I'm feeling myself like.
Yeah, no, you have to shoot.
Yeah. I don't want people to take it.
Not at all, bro.
You got to be honest.
If you do,
a lot about confidence as well.
Yeah, no.
Do you know why I'm taking this confidence?
Yeah,
it's because I know what the stuff that I've done and this has come off nothing, bro. I know what
put into it.
The people that's hollered at me and brother is crazy.
But also in the line of work that you're in, bro, if it's not yourself giving you confidence, it ain't coming from no one else.
Yeah.
Because once you flop, you die alone. You're dead on your own, bro.
Brother,
so It's on you only.
This is what I'm
always
saying. See, when people say don't gas yourself up, you have to. You got to gas yourself up. You got to say you're the best.
No, what I have, especially this line of work, you have to.
100%.
Bro, in life.
100%.
Not only in life.
Yeah,
bro. Also comedy. Because comedy, you're on your own.
Let me put into perspective. Yeah, there's a guy. Yeah, who was sent, the first guy to sell rubber bands, you know, rubber bands.
Yeah.
Yeah. He was trying to pitch it and tell people to buy, and people would like, rubber bands, what?
Do I need it?
Ended up becoming a millionaire.
Yeah.
Do you get what I'm trying to say? Yeah, my whole, my point in that thing is that he believed in his product so much, yeah. And he told himself, this is going to be a thing. This is going to be the best. This is going to, and he pushed it and he became so successful. Now people are, the people that said no, one of, and don't get me wrong. If you don't know, if you don't have any knowledge about whatever it is, obviously you will say no, and you know what I mean, you won't. My point is, in general,
believe in your source.
I was flat. Thank you. You saved my death.
I got you.
I was flying.
It's okay, it happens. It happens. It's okay.
But it happens. Bro,
I got you.
Yeah, believe in your source, man.
Nah,
but, yeah, anyways, but fam.
Nah, it has to be, yeah, especially when you're doing comedy.
It wasn't just holler. When a man hollers at you at a certain hour,
he wants you to
in
see
the
it,
morning.
Yeah.
You get that? He's been thinking about it.
Yeah, he didn't sleep.
Oh, okay. was it that early?
Brother!
He didn't sleep.
Even the birds didn't chirp yet. What are you talking about? The birds even woke up like, nigga, I ain't even chirped yet. How the fuck? You messaging my man. Brother, yeah, nah, bro. Trust me. It was so early, even birds were like, yo, what's going on with
what's
this?
What's going on here, yeah.
But trust me.
Imagine
man. But that's when but this is the thing. You see, with this type of thing, or this whole game, you gotta really be careful.
Who you bring along?
Forget even bring along. Who you're around, who you're surrounded by.
Mm.
My circle's so tight, bro.
As it should be, though, while I have
tight, bro. I'm getting DMs of man them, oh yeah, like, can we do skits? Can we collab? And don't get me wrong, I do believe in giving people chances.
Mm.
But you don't know the intentions. But you just about know the intentions of your brethren.
Facts. Mm. Even yourself, even on a yourself, deeper level.
You know Allah,
bro, yourself alone.
So how are you gonna
know someone else's, yeah.
It's just extra, it's Mother Hanum, bro.
Wallahi, big Mother Hanum. I like that.
Shambalaza. Brother, Monzz is the man of the people, bro. I'll speak any language for you guys.
As I'm trying to say.
Come on, bro. He speaks Arabic.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, bro. Tell him Arabic, bro. I'm here, bro. I'm outside, man. Shwaya, all of that. And say, where are you from?
Morocco.
Ah, Morocco, yeah? Maghrib, yeah?
Maghrib.
My brother, man.
Come on.
Yeah, man.
Man of the people, bro.
Man of the people.
Outside, but.
Come on.
But yeah, my point, yeah, I'm saying. So, like, I try to stay away from collabs with big people unless it's business. Do you know what I'm saying? Now, don't get me wrong. Like, I would love to do a collab with certain
people. Of course.
Do you know what I'm trying to say? Right now, I just want to find myself.
That's what I was going to say, yeah.
And my team, we're like the new vibe now. We're like the new batch of this comedy thing. Like, it's, do you know what I'm saying?
And you know what's mad? Like, sorry to cut you off. Yeah, like, even like, people forget that you've been doing this for a little while. You know, people just see the success, but that's life in general. Yeah. People see the success now, only even reach where you, you've not touched your potential.
Yeah.
But people see you now in a lot more places and they'll be like, oh yeah, this is new. But they don't know that you've been.
The work you've
done. The catalog you've got.
Bro, you see my team. I remember how it would take us near enough 5 hours, bro, to shoot a 1 minute skit, brother.
That's mad.
Now we're shooting skits like this.
And the thing is, when you're watching it, you don't get that vibe.
You don't.
It's flawless.
This is the thing.
Yeah, you don't
this
see the effort.
When people holler for business and promo, they want me to do a skit promoting whatever they're thinking.
Thinking it's going to take 2-3 minutes. Yeah.
In my mind, I'm thinking, brother,
it's not like that.
Yeah, man. Mm. Sometimes you have to break it down.
5 hours.
You know what I'm saying? Not anymore, man. The sauce is different now. We're trying to, you get me, find the right ingredients. But now, I'm saying, but yeah, man, it's one of those situations. But going on to my story with regards to like the whole, now social media started to boom, things are moving, people are now making their own shows via YouTube. Like, shout out to my boy Michael Dapper, he done the whole swill thing. Yep. I said, cool, shit, boy, I can do my thing now. And it's good when I see brothers like that doing their thing. I even went to my uni, that's my guy as well.
Oh, okay.
He's doing his thing. I'm proud, like, when I'm seeing
of course. Yeah, it's motivation for you as well. Yeah, well, that is, man.
And yeah, man, started to do his thing, and I thought, yeah, I could do my thing, man. And then I found my way through the videos, and I realized, okay, let me try and like level up. I used to do videos by myself, like put on a stand.
I've seen those earlier ones, yeah.
And then, yeah, hanging off the laptops. Weird, man. Just trying to find places to make.
Yeah, but everyone, like, even when we were chatting to Chunks, Chunks today was doing the same thing, which is putting on top of his laptop. Everyone's
Chunks as well, man. And Darkus in that team, that man, are funny. But do you know what I'm saying? Like, my thing was, then after
I leveled up,
I had a videographer in the ends, my brethren said, let's try something like.
Let's link up, yeah.
Yeah, we done it. We used to, do you know how deep it was? I remember our first ever skit, yeah. One of our first ever skit was when you actually find the ice cream in the ice cream container.
That bro.
Brother.
Wallahi, different. I was fucking crying. Brother, I don't know if people have seen it, but wallahi. Because obviously coming from African households,
you
bro.
You already know what
wallahi, I was in tears, bro. Wallahi.
Bro, do you know when I realized, that I was different with it?
And can I say the song?
Even now when I look at it.
The song that you picked was sensational, bro. Wallahi, sensational.
It was sensational.
You know what, a man humbly acknowledges.
He knows. It was a great song choice, Wallahi.
Bro, I remember. Yeah, even now when I look back at it, I'm like, this was a hard.
Oh, Wallahi's calling.
I was on a different. That's great, bro. But I was been. But I remember one of my skits. Me and my brethren and my videographer, we travelled from South to all the way to Staines, because my brethren had like mansion yard thing, like, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And because we didn't have like yards available, like
you can't do it in family house. Yeah, yeah. Say, people like, what the hell's going on?
We didn't have bread like that to rent out, and we didn't believe in it like that, man.
Yeah.
But we believed it enough to travel all the way to Staines.
No, I rate that. Yeah, well, I
so we
that.
Drove all the way to Staines to shoot a video. A 1 minute skit, bro.
That's mad.
That was the dedication. And I thought to myself, because that was so long.
That's mad.
I felt like, are we gonna have to do this all the time?
All the time.
Yeah.
But you have to you have to find your formula. Then social media started to get bigger with the whole TikToks and all of that.
Whatever, not
yet. Rather, I started to find it, like,
you found your rhythm.
Yeah, rather, you found the mojo.
Yeah, then, yeah.
Different.
Bro, remember, Monkweh, the name Monkweh came out of nowhere, bro. Literally. I remember hearing, I think I was watching a Nollywood film, just one of those.
I was
going
to ask
things,
you, where did the name Monkweh come
from? Monzz is, so Monzz, like, obviously, I'm not going to hurt my God.
Yeah, but. Yeah.
Wait.
It was close.
Nah, you're going to laugh. You're laughing like it's a mad thing. It's not a mad thing.
It's not that.
I'm just saying, I don't want to, because there's weirdos that.
No, thanks.
You know what I'm saying?
We do the same, though.
We've all got nicknames. That's why I'm laughing, bro. Yeah, I like
it. Yeah. So, you see, everyone knows, man, as Monzz, innit?
Yeah.
So I need to keep the Monzz bit. Do you know what I mean?
Okay.
So I remember I saw something, and I heard someone say something in one of Nollywood films. I think the person said, Abu Kwekweh. Kwekweh.
Yeah.
Abu Kwekweh. Abu Kwekweh. Abu. I loved it. It was just Kwekweh. Monkweh. Monkweh. Brother.
Clicked.
Monkweh.
Yeah.
Brother. The mad thing from there now, is what people need to understand is that when I realized I was doing the mad thing is when Real Ferdinand hit man up. And he hit man up saying, Monkweh.
That's mad.
Bolasi. Even though you unfollowed me, I don't care about your football club anyway. But shout out to Velasi, but nah, I was bitter about that.
No,
it doesn't matter.
Right,
it doesn't matter though. It's cool, isn't it? But just know that I know. So yeah. Don't big man up. Nah, joking. Shout out to Velasi. But anyways, Hesky, all of these man, and Monkweh.
That's mad.
You know what I'm saying? It's mad, bro.
So humbling as well, especially that obviously the journey that you sort of come from. And he's a man that obviously you're a football man, so you've seen this man from when you was a youth
growing up
so, and then big Rio Ferdinand is saying,
shouting me off a name that I made out of finish.
Yeah.
Do you know what the mad thing is? I remember watching Man United and Arsenal. I was FaceTiming Rio Ferdinand watching it.
Oh, that's mad.
Crazy. Yeah, that's
when you scored a goal, I was like,
that's mad.
Then he'll lock off, then
he'll call you back.
Obviously, I weren't trying to answer, but I'm picking up the phone, like,
yeah, you can't say
that. Then, so boom, boom, brother.
It's humbling, though. Yeah, humbling. It must be mad, or like.
But, bro, there's more people, bro. I got that Usman from years.
I was gonna say, yeah. Cause it must be mad. Cause all these big Kerry celebs Hilton, coming on your comment section,
coming in, following. Bro, like, Kerry Hilson didn't follow, but she. I don't care.
She doesn't matter. She's commenting, bro.
They're showing love and.
But
they're coming to your page, bro. That's enough.
All of these people starting to pick up, like, do you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
And guys,
that
used,
limousine pulling in.
It was.
It's coming. It's coming soon.
Bro, but anyways, yeah, man. It just started to pick up, like, and then, brother, it was. Yo, there's so many names, like, so.
But even
names,
like some of the skits. Obviously, I've got a few personal my fave.
Yeah.
I think my personal favorite one is the gorilla one. Wallah, I was crying.
Wallah,
I cried. I actually cried, laughing tears.
Which one?
When he said, "Do I look like a gorilla referee?" I was fucking. I was in tears. The Mango Lassie one.
Yeah.
Even the most recent one where I think it's like your partner and she chat shit to a group of guys.
Blanco.
And then you play this woman's work in the background.
Yeah.
I was crying.
My favorite one, bro. My favorite one is Miranda Man. Half Jamaican. Bro, that
I thought
one,
that was my weakest one.
Wallah, that was my favorite. I can't remember what you said. You were like, oh, you know the thing, Na'ala Bokum. Yeah. Like, bro, when I heard that, Wallah, I started busting up, bro.
Yeah, bro.
That's when I knew you. I didn't even know you were Sudanese until I heard that. I said, oh, shit.
Yeah, because a lot of people must think, obviously, you're from different parts of Africa, innit? A lot of people must think you're Nigerian or West African.
That's what I thought.
I thought you were West African.
All of that.
That's what I thought.
You know what I mean? The whole character, Monkweh, is not like, remember, I've watched a lot of films from everywhere.
Yeah.
Well cultured.
Man of the people.
With Monkweh, I thought, man of the people.
Yeah.
People's
Monkweh,
chat.
I thought, cool, this character is going to be based of an African man, not particularly a man from here or from there.
Just it represents Africa.
Even when they say, whenever I had like interviews or podcasts and they say, where's Monkweh from? Where's that character originate from? I can't say Sudan because he's not represented.
Yeah.
And I can't say a Nigeria or West Africa because, although I'm using that kind of accent.
Of course,
I can't say I'm moving like a Nigerian car.
Yeah,
I'm not, then I'm kind of taking a piss. So that's why I said, no, Monkweh is an African man and he's from the unknown mountains of Africa. That's what you need to know. But as African parents, the way Monkweh carries himself is pretty much like all
very
of that.
Similar, similar.
Do you know what I'm saying?
If you got bad grades, so that's what the whole Monkweh thing is about. Do you know what I'm saying? And I've got some big things coming up.
I was gonna say, obviously, even like just a quick side, and obviously, we're saying you got bare celebrities and that coming in, even like the whole KSI thing that you and him got going on. I see that you two linked up the other day
this
as well.
One was
that must have been special for you as well,
brother. Let me tell you what's great.
Obviously, he's a big man on the YouTube scene.
On your thing, innit? He done a video using one of your videos, innit, as a reference.
So look at this.
What's the score now?
7-0. I'm on the Undertaker.
That's mad, wallah.
Hey, right now, WrestleMania.
He said, bro, when I looked at him, I rolled my eyes back on some. Yeah, you better know I'm in the building. Like, that's it. I wanted the lights to go off and just show up. So the whole KSI drop, this was mad because the whole As You Can See videos started to kick off. That happened by accident, by the way.
Oh,
I was doing more of those gorilla type videos.
Find
like animal
and they're coming in the background.
And then I would, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And we were shooting that. Yeah. And then I told my bro, take this gun and just pretend to rob man. And this was just the last minute. I didn't even want to do it. As you can see, blah, blah, blah. This guy's trying to rob me. And then the gun jams. And then I went there. And then that started to kick off. Then there was a formula. Do you know what I mean? You see, even with my skits and everyone, I never write them. It's always in my head.
I was going to ask you that,
A bullet point.
You were saying that, yeah.
Yeah, you saw that, yeah?
Yeah.
A bullet point, what the skit's about, I know exactly how it's going to go in my head. And all the people that are with me are like my boys from ENDS.
That's mad.
You know what I'm saying? I know their characters. Anyways, remember, the ENDS love, man. Man's just
man
of the people. Very.
Nah,
just
facts.
Been that guy.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So, but I know particular characters that will suit
certain roles.
Remember, I've got brethren that are outside as well that's there, like in part of the ENDS, but they're not involved because even though they're funny, they just
don't want it.
Don't fit the vision. Picking certain man and it's
that will complement what you're trying to do.
And I don't even give them a script because where they're not professional actors, well, none of us are.
Yeah.
Or had any experience in a sense. Yeah. They'll overthink. This line. So I'm saying, like, for example, my man Edson. I say, Edson, I want you to say this, but how you would say it on Edson.
Yeah.
Because, brother, I know you, man. We always bust joke. I know how you'd say it.
No, facts.
My mind, I know this character. You're going to say it how I want you to say it. And he would just do, you know what I'm trying to say? Yeah. We just, it's a free flow. I never told him. Obviously, when things start getting big in terms of series and that, it's going to be a bit more scripted, you know what I mean? And get things a bit more prepared and there'll be levels of preparation. And But I still want the improv element installed in because that's when people are much more natural.
But also with improv, you can also take it whatever direction you want. That's the beauty about it. Yeah. Like, especially when done properly.
Exactly.
Bro, you could take it anywhere.
Exactly. You man ever used to watch Whose Line Is It? Or Whose Line Is It Anyway?
That rings a bell.
Back in the day, it was a show, like an improv show.
Mm. Oh, and you just say a line and everyone got to run off whatever you say.
And it was hilarious, bro. Obviously, they used to like mess up a lot of the time, but even they're messing up. Like, they're doing it in a way, obviously they're professionals, isn't it? So they're doing it in a way where they're using that now as the next joke.
It's old school show. The way you can take it is to the unknown, and that's the beauty of it.
This is what's happening in this podcast, in a sense. There's no script to this.
Facts, yeah.
That's why it flows nice. That's why, do you know what I'm saying? But it depends on the characters, bro.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, the reason why I'm here is because I know I'm gonna get this type of vibe.
Yeah.
Like, I've seen you guys not podcast. Scripted, yeah, bro, it's not scripted. You man, I'm saying there's some podcasts that you see they're really trying, like, and you get me? They're really trying, like, it's like they're trying to, you know, certain man will try and bust joke and you know, it's
yeah,
like,
forcing it.
I hear you're trying.
The moonwalking.
It's not moonwalking. I mean, you get me, like. But do you know why it's that? It's like, obviously, I'm not trying to shit on anyone
Of course.
They're overthinking.
Yeah.
They think, we've got a podcast. We need to make it funny somehow. And sometimes it'll be man that don't even talk about the topics. They're not even involved in topics like that. Like, it's not even their thing. Do you know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
Nah, it's always like, even we've always said, like, anytime we've ever wanted to, we just always wanted it to be sort of like organic and just flow, because obviously the viewers at home can see if it's not organic. That's the main thing.
As I said, I watched you guys. I said, I got, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Alhamdulillah, it happened though.
It's been a long road.
Before we sort of wrap. Like, what's next for like Monkweh? What you got coming up? Like 2023 and onwards, inshallah. What's the plan?
To be honest, 2023 is too far.
This year
it's kicking off.
I love that.
My bro.
Yeah,
it's definitely not over, bro.
Without obviously saying too much, I know you don't want to give away that.
I'm really.
Just heard him say 100 times.
He looked at the mic twice and he said
motherfucker.
But there's big things coming,
bro. It's time for me to really. It's either that, or you know what I'm saying, or stay in IT and then just be behind the desk not rubbishing anyone. I love my thing.
I love it, but it's not you.
It's not me.
Yeah.
Either that or I'm just repetitive. Like, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I'm talking about myself.
Of course.
You know what I'm saying? Not.
Yeah, of course.
This is why you see the podcasting.
But wallahi, no.
I ain't trying to mock anybody, man. I'm talking about myself.
It's not even a mock, bro. It's like,
not
like,
mock.
Everyone's life is different. His journey is different, wallahi, bro.
Me, I'll be honest with you. I come from a family of like, bro, where we're from in Sudan, it's nothing, bro. Like, my parents, my dad per se, he would tell me, bro, like him and his brothers, the way they'll study, if the electric cuts, it's 3-4 candles up.
That's mad.
They have to find a way, and the next day they'll probably have an exam. It's a mad thing.
That's like mad. Yeah.
Things have to go on. They're not gonna. The examiners don't do the whole. The electricity's cut.
Yeah.
Postpone it, bro. Find a way.
Yeah.
Find a way, like, and from where we're from in Sudan, And big up my dad, man. Both my parents, man. All our parents, them up, facts, man. All our parents, bro. Where we're from, some people there think making it is making it to the city.
Yeah.
Because that's all they know. Like, it's that one direction. It's like, yeah. If I get to the capital city, yeah. I can make a life
for myself. Yeah.
But for my dad to think outside the box, bro. For my dad went to India. He studied in India.
That's mad.
And then after went to America, married my mom, then came London, then went back to America. He's an aerospace engineer. He does
Allah,
and
Barak,
my mom kind of Allah. Thank you, mom. And my mom started to my mom's a nurse. Mm. Okay. You know what I'm saying? So she found her way here, and then it was just like they're both trying to figure out what's the best place. And then obviously me and my sister, we got settled school here. And
of course, yeah, don't make too much.
The pattern where my dad would work, and then because he's an aerospace engineer for United, he'll get like tickets to
come back, yeah,
seasonal. So he tried to find a job here, but they tried to.
It's not the same.
It's not even that. They'll tell him Scotland and Manchester. Yeah, and it's so like if you're gonna be away, you might as well be. Mm. Do you know what I mean? Yeah, and it was fun for us as well, car. We get free tickets. We'll go to America.
That's sick.
It was fun, man. So it was. That was how it was.
So there was a small chance Monkweh could have been American.
Could have been. Yeah. Could have been, man. I could have been like, hey, Shouty.
Hey,
Shouty. You really know, man. Monkweh, bitch. You're down, bro. You average London ass niggas, man. This is Monkweh, bitch. Yeah, the bro.
Life would have been so different. Margins. It's all
bro, it's all about margins. Margins. Things, you know what I'm saying? A lot of things. Where I'm going with my whole point is my dad's been that guy of going to get it and making it happen.
Mm. Yeah.
Not settling. He didn't settle. Do you get what I'm trying to say? Now, remember, there's some people that are happy to settle.
Facts.
If they're in whatever position they are.
Yeah, yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, and alhamdulillah, if you are.
If that's your risk, that's your risk. Yeah, wallahi, bro. Yeah.
Do you know what I'm trying to say? If you, you know.
If you're comfortable.
Whatever job you're doing, if you're comfortable.
And you're happy?
That's Do your you're happy, brother.
All the
I wish
best.
You all the best.
Yeah, yeah.
But if you're not, or if there's limitations, bro. Yeah, if there's moments. Bro, in my mind, I think it's mad that you have, that you can work the whole year. Because remember, when we was at school, we'd go to school and we'd have a summer holiday.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? We'd have so much of a break that it feels calm. But at work, you'd have like a 28-day or 5-day, 25 days or 21 days.
For the whole year.
Do you know what I'm trying to say? And the summer holiday doesn't even feel like a summer holiday.
Yeah.
No.
Like summer holiday now, it just felt like. I remember like, you know, I just thought to myself, oh, summer's coming. But in my mind, I'm not at school, bro. I'm not at uni, bro. I'm not. It still has to work.
There's shit waiting for you and like, responsibilities.
There's still things going in that. So it's not. But now we're social media and there's so much opportunities like with information, like the internet booming and being able to gain information where you can start your own businesses, start your own podcasts.
Yeah.
And you know, and inshallah you guys get a deal like a Spotify or something beautiful. But you know what I'm saying? Inshallah.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. I know you guys are not just doing, it might be a hobby in some sense, but if there's ways to make peace from it, and surely there is, I'm sure you guys know about that.
Of course,
you obviously put this in an avenue which you try and make peace from it, and you're going to make peace on something that you enjoy.
No,
and this could be a side thing for my, do you know what I'm trying to say? So it's about finding happiness and on what you do, not settling, and pretty
also
much
putting the energy in as
that's
well.
What I'm saying.
Putting the
and,
work.
And you, like, as much as I do love IT, like, as much as I do love like what I do, and obviously because you know I graduated in computer science and whatnot, the comedy has always been me, bro.
It's always been your passion,
Do you know and that's something you can always fall back on. Like that's not even the end of the world for you, Allah. Like even like
there we go.
God willing, that's, forbid, sorry.
That's what and that's what my dad was on. My dad was on.
Always have a contingency.
My dad was like the comedy thing is you can't do comedy first, bro. Like.
Facts.
Do your uni thing. Just
okay.
Being a man. Just you gotta be. Control my life.
He's trying to prepare you. Wallah.
Get the education thing, and the way he would say it is a bit mad. Sometimes like, yo, education, nothing. Like it wasn't like trying to make man understand. It was just more. Trust me, I know this.
Yeah.
Because where I'm from, if I didn't pattern my education, we wouldn't be here.
Yeah.
So Do you know what I'm trying to say? Nice. But I didn't know that. He never explained it to me. It was more educational. You are going to die. Yeah. No, but I'm just saying.
And like, when you're a youth, you're not trying to hear that. It's like, lie it, man. Lie it, man. It's always lie. Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But as you grow, you become wiser.
You appreciate it.
And now, alhamdulillah, if the comedy thing doesn't work out, which I'm not going to allow it not to.
Yeah, of course. You put that safety net back already.
That's a safety net there ready for you.
So, yeah, man. And that's it. But I can't settle. There's so much stuff I want to do, bro. Like, from even back home, yeah, my aunt, like, this one's a bit personal, but I have to say why my drive is much more, like, why I'm going. My auntie passed away because of She passed away because of poor healthcare in Sudan. Yeah, and I'm sure there is in many
of course
I'm trying to say where I see like there's an avenue of like being an influencer. There's ways in which you can even if I create like a if KSI for example because of how big he is or anybody else that's kind of got a big name if he has a GoFundMe and says listen guys I'm going to help this charity and because of his popularity
more people are likely to
help. Do you get what I'm trying to say? So I'm not doing my comedy to be the Monkweh, bro. Like, calm. I don't get me wrong. I love the love and everything, and I do want to change. Like,
but you've got a bigger purpose.
You got a bigger purpose.
Yeah. But, bro,
bigger fish to
fry. As a Muslim, bro,
I love that. Yeah, her, man.
Like, and I'm not. It's not a dunya thing. Like, it's, as a Muslim, I know. Like, whatever I'm blessed with, I'm make sure. You know, you're gonna
give back.
Use that to a way
you, positive way.
That's what I'm saying. Inspire the youth, man. So, I'm not, bro. I honestly, I'd rather like. I know this may sound brazy, yeah, but I'd rather an Apple Watch than a Rolly. I know, let me hear me out. Let me hear you out.
Wallahi, I respect that. Wallahi,
okay,
bro.
Okay, cool.
Wallahi, I respect that, bro.
So,
and I love that.
Obviously, the Rolly thing, there's investments in that, but in the business, cool, we get it. Yeah, I'm saying, but I'd rather, this is just much more useful to me. Can answer phones, you can talk about that. For me, that's brazy, bro. This is that's cold. Like,
it's a nice
I'd rather
thing
that
have.
Type of thing.
Facts, it's a nice thing to have, but it's not something you need to have.
But this is the thing. People, as I said, look, at the end of the day, I don't judge people who don't give charity anything, but I just feel like if you're put in a position where you're blessed, remember, giving charity is not just about giving financially.
Yeah.
It could be just a conversation.
Smile.
It could be a
facts.
Smile, my
bro.
This is
the simplest
thing.
Well,
that's what I'm trying to say.
And people
like
forget
my man,
that.
You remember when I bombed and my man come up to me and said,
yeah,
like,
see that.
That's a charity.
And the fact that you're saying it today, look at how much it means to him.
That's what I'm saying. You don't know how far it can get.
Yeah.
How far I can go. Do you know what I'm trying to
say? It's not something that's often like, shared around as well.
Like, yeah, exactly.
Allah.
You see the whole influencer thing, whatever. People get it. They think now, like, there's certain people that it gets to their head. Like, where you even meet them, they act like, raw, like, who are you? Like,
yeah.
You know what I'm trying to say? But no, bro.
It's not about
it's
that,
always
man.
Good to kind of like, bro, it's when I meet people, I'm just trying.
That's how it should be, though. Wallahi, like, there's such beauty in kindness, bro.
It's
like,
so
much beauty in kindness. And people gravitate towards it. Like, whenever you're kind and you've got a smile on your face, or even just showing love, like, people naturally gravitate towards me. And they just want, they show you more love and they show you much more.
Bro,
like,
you gotta
things.
Understand as well. Without these people that have been supporting
you're nothing.
You're nothing.
You're dead, bro. Wallahi.
Bro, nobody is better than anyone. Anyways, you know what I'm trying to say? Remember that. You're thinking
just like that.
I know
Wallahi.
The comedy thing. People love Monkweh right now, but then one day it could be Monkweh. But that's where I know my comedy brain, my genius behind this whole thing. I know, okay, cool. I can't keep doing that, as you can see. Or if I'm going to do it, I need to take it to another.
Yeah, there's always, you got to keep it moving.
I know there's people that's still going to love it, but I can't keep it.
You can't stay in the same section
know,
the whole time. You
got
to keep.
There we go. But there's still more levels. Bro, I've got so many projects. I've written up to 8 projects. Full on projects, 6 episodes each.
I love that, man.
And these are things that I've been writing from way back.
Okay.
So now that I'm now kind of getting like the buzz and stuff.
Yeah.
Bro,
I can't wait for that one.
Oh my, it's a shawatting on everything. Get
West Side said he wants to be one of your skits, though. So, West Side, we'll make that happen for you, bro.
You got a role for him, yeah? You got a role for him.
Bro.
We got a role for you.
There you go, bro. He told me off camera he's a bit shy right now, isn't it, my guy? But like, we'll get you a little skit, a little part in there. Just to sort of finish off, like, or like, we appreciate you coming on here, and also like may Allah make everything easy for you, bro. Especially like the vision that you had. Like, people often sort of forget that what your bigger picture is a beautiful thing. And wallahi, may Allah make it easy for you. May Allah grant you everything your heart desires, bro. Like, yeah. These things is, as you know, the comedy thing is always like going to be up and down. But obviously your dad instilled in you something that you'll never forget in your life, and that's just to give it your all. And it's for moments like that it's where you are now.
And you know
what, it's not gonna take you off.
One thing that you said that I love, because I've always thought it as well, you know, a lot of people, they're in a situation or whatever that they're not happy with, right? Mm. And they'll complain about that situation, but they do nothing to change it.
Yeah.
That's one thing. It's like, I've never ever, I've done it as well, but I had to kind of check myself and be like, you complain about it, but what have you done to not be in that position? And a lot of people do that. And I think if you just take yourself out of it and think, all right, cool, you know what? I don't like this job.
Yeah.
But I'm going to do something about it. Not just tell the man them I don't like it, and then I'm still going to turn up to work and not be late. Like, also, do something about it.
Also, I want to say, just for anything, I don't want anybody to kind of look at me and be like, yo, on a role model thing and that, you know what I'm saying? I'm still learning. I'm still trying to improve as a person. Do you know what I'm saying? Trying to be the best that I can be. Do you know what I'm saying? So I don't want anybody to look at me and be like, yo, I want to be like Monkweh. It's not adapting. It's, do you know what I'm trying to say? It's follow your path. I feel like just be a good person. You don't have to follow anybody in terms of wanting to be like somebody else. Just be the best version of you.
Mm. I love that.
Well, that's beautiful, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, I love that. I was going to say, I was going to ask him for a final word, innit? But wallahi, give it to you, please. So wallahi, yeah. Wallahi, I appreciate that. Thank you for coming on. Obviously, hopefully this won't be the last time, though.
Oh, no.
Don't act bougie again next time.
It's on camera now. Said it now. You agreed, big man.
Cameraman. You know how to cut that out.
No,
we didn't agree on this.